apparently Steve Cohen is going to make a run at Brian Cashman next year, try to swipe him away from the Yankees. Did you see that?
Yeah, but realistically, I don't think that's going to happen, right? Like, we don't really think that's going to happen.
I mean, it would be – I think it would be the craziest story, Yankee story, in a very long time, because Cashman's been with the organization for, like, 30 years or some shit. All of a sudden, he's just going to up and go. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Why would he leave? And especially, why would he go from the Yankees to the Mets? I mean, come on, guys. Let's be real here.
Well, I think for him, it would be more of, like, a challenge, like – you know, how much credit does Brian Cashman get for World Series? Like, let me show you what I can do with the Mets. That's a team that's snake bitten, clearly.
I think that his reputation is starting to change a little bit. A lot of people like to shit on Brian Cashman, and I get it. I understand that he's been here for a long time. He's pretty much had an open checkbook for most of his career. So, you know, maybe he wasn't as responsible as everybody makes it out to be for the early championships. But if you think about this season, the guys that have carried this team were Brian Cashman moves. We're talking Gio Urshela is having a great season for the Yankees. That's a Brian Cashman move. Luke Voit, traded for Chasen Shreve to the St. Louis Cardinals. That's a Brian Cashman move. A lot of these maneuvers, the fact that Gleyber Torres is on this team, that's a Brian Cashman move. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of this is attributed to Cashman. It's not just opening the checkbook like they did for Gerrit Cole this year. So I'm starting to kind of be on his corner. I've always been on his corner. I'm a Yankees fan. But I think a lot of the criticism is uncalled for. I think Yankees fans are super impatient and irrational sometimes. But you're not going to get that here, guys.
What would Brian Cashman be coming to with the Mets, by the way? Like, besides DeGrom, Pete Alonso's regressed a little bit, even though he's hit a lot of home runs for a shortened season. I think he's at 11. I think the leader in the NL is, last time we spoke, was 16. Mm-hmm. So I think 11 home runs is a good number of home runs in a 60-game season. Mm-hmm. But besides Jacob DeGrom, like, what is he coming to? Like, an aging Cano with a lot of money on the table that he's owed?
You know what? Like, even the Mets roster, I feel like they're not as bad as we think they are. Like, Dominic Smith has been a beast this season. You have a good offense in that team. You have, I know, like you said, Pete Alonso is struggling. He's batting .202 with a .713 OPS. But maybe it's a sophomore slump. Maybe we see the real Pete Alonso next year, or maybe this is the real Pete Alonso. We don't know. But anyway, we have Jeff McNeil, who's a really good hitter. A guy like Michael Conforto in our net run stat, he was in the top 25 as recent as last week. So he's a decent hitter. You have, Cano can still swing the bat. He was raking for a couple of weeks there. I think they have a good enough team. You're going to have Syndergaard is going to come back next year. DeGrom. And if they're smart, they should go out and get another starting pitcher, maybe Trevor Bauer. Somebody like that, or get a bullpen arm like a Kirby Yates. Because if you look at what the fuck is his name? Oh my God, Eduardo
Rodriguez.
Oh my God. if you look at his numbers, he's actually having a really good season. I just think maybe he can't handle the pressure of the ninth inning.
No, I'm sorry. So Eduardo Rodriguez is a pitcher for the Red Sox. Edwin Diaz.
Yes.
We're a baseball podcast. These things.
We don't fact check. He's having a pretty good season. I think that maybe he can't handle the pressure of the ninth inning. Move him up to the eighth inning. And all of a sudden, Jerry Familia is a seventh inning pitcher. He's not, you know, in the eighth inning setting up for Diaz. Yes.
Did you just admit there's a such thing as a ninth inning pressure? did we just have a breakthrough moment here?
Okay,
and welcome to the show podcast.
I believe that a pitcher... I feel like it's a mindset thing. I feel like a pitcher can make the moment bigger than what it really is. And I feel like Edwin Diaz is one of those guys who, in that moment, the pressure of that moment gets to him. So maybe he needs to know that there's going to be somebody else that comes after him, that it's not going to fall on his shoulders. But I feel like he has the skill set. If he could just get out of his head, like A-Rod always did, you know what I mean? I've been going to say A-Rod, a little A-Rod. Nope. Shade. I don't know. I don't know what I'm trying to say.
You know what I think would be an interesting stat to look at? Sorry to cut you off.
Let's hear it.
How closers do in home games versus away games, because technically, like, there's more pressure to close a game out away, because if you blow it, it's over.
Yeah, you know? That's true.
So it'd be interesting to look at that. But
what I'm trying to say is that the Mets aren't as bad as we think they are. I think that Brody Van Wagenen is a fucking idiot. Let's just put that out there. And I love Luis Rojas. Let's give him another season, part of the Alou family. I'm not gonna throw shade at that guy. But I don't know. I just feel like they've just been run poorly. I feel like the franchise is almost like snake bit or something. And maybe Steve Cohen coming in will wipe the slate clean. The guy's gonna apparently spend money. He's willing to spend money. So let's see what he does with that money.
So I think the Mets up until recently, I don't know about the last couple of days, were the number one team in terms of like batting average, weighted runs created plus. Wow, you like that stat.
Ah, WRC plus.
You didn't think I knew about that, but I do. It's not translating into wins. Obviously, guys like Michael Wacha, Rick Porcello are having terrible seasons.
Yeah, man.
Literally, Jacob DeGrom is the only one. I don't even know what happened to Steven Matz anymore. Like, what's up with that guy? Is he out of the bullpen now at this point?
They just let Zach Wheeler go. You know what I mean? Like,
so it's almost like the Mets can never click at the same time. No. Right? And maybe they're not hitting in the situations where runners are in scoring positions, because I feel like even though DeGrom's yesterday they didn't score enough runs for him, but his two previous starts they scored a lot, double digit runs in both of those starts. But maybe they're just not doing it in situational hitting, you know.
By the way,
I do think they're
first in. Yeah, first in batting average, first in on base. You were right. First in WRC plus. And second in WOBA, which is like an enhanced version of slugging. Like it's a better measure. Yeah.
Can you actually explain WOBA to us, or do you actually not know what that is? And I'm putting you on the spot.
Yeah. The problem is like I can't explain how it's calculated. The way that I understand it is that it's an enhancement of slugging. Like average just tells you how many hits a player has per at bat. On base tells you how often a player gets on base, obviously. Slugging tells you more like the type of hitter that he is. Like, yeah, he has this type of batting average, but he's more of a power hitter versus a contact hitter. WOBA is even more accurate. Like it gives you a more accurate picture of who the hitter is. It's like it's an enhancement of slugging. That's the way that I think about it. How do you calculate it? I have no fucking clue. That's the problem with these stats, is that they're confusing as fuck.
Well, I know that when they ever have that plus or the weighted, it's more, the weighted.
Adjusted to the park and stuff like that.
Yeah, it's adjusted to the park. Yeah, all that stuff. So guys in Coors Field will have like lower WOBAs and.
Truth.
I'm into it. I'm hip to the new lingo.
Do you know what? You know what stat people should get into, though? Net runs, man. That's all I'm saying, man.
We got to come up with a more catchier name than net runs.
I know. There has to be a catchier name, like weighted net runs plus jizz or something. I don't know. Like, I have no idea. Titties.
Yeah.
Titty runs. I just brought us down a whole bunch of notches. But anyway.
This is not getting recommended to anybody. No.
And by the way, how if we were to break this up into multiple episodes, what would that, like, if we ended the segment right now, what would that first episode be?
I would say it would have been about Brian Cashman and maybe going to the Mets.
Okay.
That seems like a good way to segue.
All right.
To something else.